Hey, my precious brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother broadcasting to you on demand from the extraordinary country of the Philippines here on this 2015th year of our Lord. Yes, the Latin AD means year of our Lord. Jesus Christ here, May the 3rd, Sunday, brothers and sisters. Praise God for his holy name. Blessed be his holy name, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. For he is worthy to receive all praise and glory. Hallelujah. You know, brothers and sisters, I just posted a video by Dr. Kolauma on the channel. I invite you to listen to his testimony of all the great and mighty things the Lord is doing through the feeding programs of Joshua's ministry. Praise God, brothers and sisters. It's growing by gangbusters. The churches are overflowing. I had to give them a money straight away last night at the house blessing of Orphanage Number 3. Because we need to buy 50 chairs immediately, these plastic chairs immediately. And that's not enough. You know, that's the amount of money that I had to give them, you know, on hand. Brothers and sisters, we have a mighty explosion of salvations in Joshua's ministry here. And I just want to praise the Lord. I ask you guys to come in agreement with me in praising the Lord. Thank God Almighty. God's still on the throne. And that's what I wanted to talk to you guys about in this message that the Lord gave me. The Lord, you know, has always given me so many messages. Praise God. And just lately, the last few weeks, almost every night, the Lord has given me dreams. And brothers and sisters are coming to pass. Even for individuals, brothers and sisters, several different people, the Lord's given me dreams for. And I've got to contact you, those who the Lord has given me dreams about. And they're coming to pass, Lord. The Lord's things that he's given me are coming to pass. The dreams and visions, praise God. Praise God for that, brothers and sisters, because in every message that the Lord gives me, he keeps telling me that the rapture is at hand. The rapture is within, you know, about the four blood moons and all those things, a time of four, brothers and sisters. So praise God. God's still on the throne. And that's what I'm trying to tell you guys, even though, you know, there's people who have made a YouTube career about all the bad news going on in the world. But I'm here to tell you, no matter what bad news, whatever bad report you've heard, God's still on the throne. Praise his holy name. You know, brothers and sisters, the story, speaking of Joshua's, the Lord is reminding me, you know, about Joshua. You know, the Joshua from the Bible, Joshua, son of Nun. Bless that brother in Christ who has been a blessing to the church throughout the Bible. Amen. Yes, all of the Old Testament saints are our brothers and sisters in Christ, because after the Lord's crucifixion, he descended into paradise, and the Bible says he led captivity captive. He preached the gospel to those Old Testament saints. One of them was our brother, Joshua, son of Nun. Now, when the children of Israel, brothers and sisters, can you imagine this? Imagine this. You know, just as we are facing the tribulation, just as the world is facing the tribulation, and particularly in this case, the nation of Israel will go through the tribulation. We, the bride of Christ, will be kept out of. Ek is the Greek word. Revelation 3:10. Because you have patiently kept my words, Jesus says to the church of Philadelphia, or because you have kept the word of my patience, King James, I will keep you out of the hour of temptation that will come upon the earth to try all the people of the earth. Praise God. The Greek word is ek, out of, not through, like the nation of Israel. And brothers and sisters, the nation of Israel, they went through a type of the tribulation. It's called the plagues that God did on Egypt under the ministry of Moses and his brother Aaron. Now Moses had an armor bearer. Moses had an assistant as the children of Israel left Israel, and he ended up taking over from Moses. That man was Joshua, son of Nun. Now, when the children of Israel had seen with their own eyes how God had delivered them through the plagues, how when they were in the land of Goshen, the plagues didn't come nigh them, like Psalm 91, they saw it with their eyes, but it didn't touch them. They were delivered by the blood of the Lamb, just like the Passover. And the Lord is just reminding me of another message he gave me. I'm going to throw it in here. For all you Judaizers, the Bible says, Christ our Passover. In the New Testament, it says Christ is our Passover. But in that Old Testament shadow, as it tells us, John the Baptist said in the New Testament, behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. That Lamb in the Old Testament, that shadow under the ministry of Moses, God's servant in the Old Testament, when the Lord sent the angel of death to kill the firstborn of all the house of Egypt, he told the children of Israel through Moses and Aaron, take the blood of a lamb without spot, without blemish, and put that blood over the doorpost and the lintel of your house. So in other words, like this and like this. So that's the cross. They put it over the lintels of their house. And when the angel of death, God said when the angel of death comes over the houses of the Israelites, and he would see that blood of the lamb without spot or blemish on the doors of the house, he would pass over that house. That's why they call it the Passover. Hallelujah. And today, brothers and sisters, the New Testament tells us that's another thing the Judaizers love to keep saying, the Torah, the law, the Torah. Well, the Old Testament is the law and the prophets. It's called the Tanakh in Hebrew, the entire Old Testament. And that's what we call it in English. Not the Torah, but the Old Testament. As Hebrews, the book of Hebrews in the New Testament says, written to Israelites and Judaizers, that which is old is waxed old and passing away. And sure enough, God destroyed the temple because every day they did sacrifices of lambs and goats and bulls on that Temple Mount was abomination to the blood of our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ. That's why the Lord gave them one generation to repent. As Jesus said, I must be first rejected by this generation. And then the gospel went out to the Gentiles, Romans 9 and 11, that the casting away of the nation might, you know, be, you know, the bringing in, the reconcile the Gentiles as a wild olive branch. And as Paul tells us, the Lord would graft them back in again. Hallelujah. In that same text, in the end, because they are the natural branches of the olive tree. Hallelujah. We are the wild branches. Praise God, we've been grafted in because they rejected the new covenant. But God said in the Old Testament, behold, I'll make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of David. Hallelujah. That's this testament, this new covenant, this new testament is such a kind that God doesn't ask us to die for him, but he died for us. He doesn't ask us to circumcise our flesh, but to circumcise our hearts. He doesn't ask us to rend our garments, but to rend our hearts. That's the difference between the Torah and the new covenant that God has made with us, the Gentile church. Those feasts are appointed Mohadim times. God said, for you, Israel, these are Mohadim for now, for eternity. For you, the nation of Israel. Hallelujah. But these Old Testament Mohadim, these appointed times of God with his covenant with Israel, is not in us, brothers and sisters, not in the church. No, because we have a new covenant, hallelujah, made by the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach through his flesh. In the Old Testament temple, they had the veil that was rent. And the New Testament tells us when the veil between the Holy of Holies and the holy place was rent, at the death of Christ on the cross when he gave up the ghost, it says that veil represents his flesh. The flesh of Christ was torn. Hallelujah. That we may have access through the heart of the Son of Man. Hallelujah. To the throne room of God. Hallelujah. We no more need the blood of bulls and goats. We no more need to have an earthly high priest who must shed the blood of animals for his own blood and then for his own sins, and then for the sins of the people. No, we have such a high priest who, for once and for all, the Bible says, hallelujah, one time and forever, eternity, after the order of Melchizedek, took his own blood, not the blood of bulls and goats or earthly lambs, but his own blood, and put it upon the true Ark of the Covenant, the true altar of God, which is in heaven, brothers and sisters. Not those earthly things that are a shadow of the good things that came through the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name. Hallelujah. God's still on the throne, brothers and sisters. Don't worry about Jade Helm, says the Lord God Almighty. Stop worrying about what man can do to you, because the Bible says, Jesus said, don't worry about what man can do to you, but worry about the one who can throw you body and soul into hell. There's only one. That's God, the Redeemer of mankind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's Yeshua. Yeshua, God, my salvation, hallelujah. God, my judge, the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Don't worry about what man can do to you. Stop chasing to and fro and worried about what's going on in the bad news of this world, because God is still on the throne, hallelujah. His kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, hallelujah. And he said in his word over and over again, this is a world without end, amen. The end of this age is what's coming upon us, brothers and sisters, but not an end of this world, for God will renew this earth, hallelujah. The Bible says he will renew, is the word there. He will renew the heavens and the earth, hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Only thing ending is this age of sin and death, this reign since the day of Adam until now. Hallelujah. God put an end. He's putting an end to all these things, brothers and sisters. Praise God. And in the meantime, we are saved. Our spirit is saved through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. Praise his holy name, brothers and sisters. God is still on the throne. He's still ruling and reigning. Hallelujah. His kingdom is in our hearts today, brothers and sisters. But the day is coming when his kingdom will rule and reign on this earth. Hallelujah. As he puts an end to death, hell, and the grave. When he puts an end to the world, the flesh, and the devil. Hallelujah. As we reign with him on this earth, his true bride, born again Christians, who don't look after those things of the Old Testament, brothers and sisters, but look after those things that's in Christ in the New Testament. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise his name. May you be found in Christ today, brothers and sisters, not counting into your own works, not trusting in your own wisdom and knowledge. Hallelujah. And the Lord had given me another nugget before. I wasn't even going to make this video the way I am, but it's the leading of the Lord. The Lord gave me a nugget, another nugget for you, brothers and sisters. Those old Judaizers, they'll even tell you that, oh, God speaks Hebrew. I've heard a lot of these Judaizers say, oh, Hebrew is the language of God speaks in heaven. Hebrew is the language of God. If you can't say Yeshua HaMashiach and speak in Hebrew, then you are not speaking the language that came from God in the very beginning. Well, listen to me, brothers and sisters, for the Lord just spoke to me a nugget and I wasn't even thinking on this topic. Hear the wisdom of God, for God's wisdom is above all wisdom of man. As he says, my ways are not your ways. Just as the heavens are above the earth, so are my ways above your ways. And the God has given us all the wisdom right in his word. But brothers and sisters, you have to have a spirit of discernment from God to understand his word. What does he say? It's so simple, says the Lord. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the apostle Paul speaking, though I speak with the tongue of men or angels, but I have not love or charity. I am nothing but a sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. I'm just making noise. But the tongue of angels or the tongues of men. Brothers and sisters, the angels have a different language. There's a different language spoken in heaven than a tongue of men. Hebrew is not the language that's spoken in heaven, brothers and sisters. But there is a language that's such a kind, a heavenly language, brothers and sisters, spoken in heaven. And brothers and sisters on this earth, we call it praying in the Spirit. Build up your most holy faith praying in the Spirit, brothers and sisters, not praying in tongues for interpretation, but praying in the Spirit, brothers and sisters. This is that kind that is a heavenly language from God. Hallelujah. Praise God. You can speak with the tongue of angels. If you have been baptized in the Holy Spirit, not the gift of tongues, I've made many videos about this, but the hard-headed, blind Pharisees and doctrinal disputings cannot simply divide the Word of God. There is a gift of tongues for interpretation, brothers and sisters. But we see in the book of Acts and the other verses I just quoted that we build up our most holy faith praying in the Spirit. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, Paul said, when I pray in the Spirit, my spirit prayeth to edify myself between me and God. And when you pray in the Spirit, pray that you have interpretation also. This is not the same as the gift of tongues that's used in the church for interpretation. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, brothers and sisters, as the Lord is leading me to repeat this information again and again and again, that by the Spirit of God, that it might bypass your doctrinal, man-made doctrines and understandings, but read the Word of God and have spiritual discernment to understand. Here is another verse for you. Acts chapter 19, verse 1, 2, and 3. It says, when Paul came to the disciples at Ephesus, he said unto them, have you received the Holy Spirit since you believed? They were already believers in Christ, and they said, we didn't even hear there was such thing as the Holy Spirit. So the Apostle Paul prayed for them. He baptized them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, And then he laid hands on them. They were filled with the Holy Spirit. And they began to speak in tongues and prophesy as the Spirit had given them utterance. Just like in Acts chapter 2, verse 38, on the original church there in Jerusalem. Brothers and sisters, we see this over and over again through the book of Acts. You must receive the Holy Spirit. You need to receive the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters. Now, the hour is late. And I have, in all my years of ministry, I have always given milk, milk, milk to babies that are not ready to accept the meat of God. But this late hour, brothers and sisters, as we are approaching the midnight hour, my God would have you be filled with His Holy Spirit. I've been mentioning this for weeks now. God desires, as the Lord is prompting me right now, just like in the Last Supper, the Lord said, I have long desired to have this meal with you. Now the Lord has a long desire that you would be filled with His Holy Spirit. And like I say, what is so abominable is millions of so-called alleged Christians. We call it Christendom. Not Christianity, not biblical Christianity, but Christendom. That means your nominal Christians included. People in Christ, who are Christians in name only, who are not truly born again. They do not desire to sup with the Lord and Him to sup with them. They just want to say, hey, have I got my ticket punched to get to heaven? I want to go to a church where the pastor gets up every week and says, I know I'm saved. I'm glad I got saved. I got saved right there at the altar. I said the sinner's prayer 40 years ago right there at the altar. Praise God, I'm saved. You're saved. We're saved. Amen. Everybody outside is going to hell, and we said a sinner's prayer. Amen, amen. We're forever forgiven. We can sin all we want. Praise God. Just like the Lord said through Paul when he was at Mars Hill. You know, in times past, you know, God has winked at these things in the ignorance of the restoration of the church from the time of the Dark Ages until now. But God is restoring His church, brothers and sisters. I'm talking about AKA the bride, the raptured church. And I'll tell you this, don't get caught up. Why do you get your theologies from truck drivers on YouTube? Why do you get your news from preachers on YouTube? The latest lie on YouTube is, oh, the church is not the bride, New Jerusalem is the bride, we're not the bride. Number one, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter which words you want to use. Who cares what words you want to use to describe those who will be raptured? But biblically speaking, they are the bride of Christ. The Lord is going to marry His bride, and it's not a city. You don't marry a city. No one would marry a city. Someone marries a person, a woman. In this case, we the church together are the body of Christ. We are the bride of Christ. You become one flesh. There's one head of a marriage, the husband. It's all a type and shadow. Everything in history, since Adam and Eve got married, it was a type and shadow of Christ and His bride. The Father and His bride, Israel. Jesus with His bride, the church. These are just words and symbols. In actuality, you know, it's a parable. Whatever term you want to use. You want to be part of the raptured bride. You want to be with Christ. You want to walk with Christ. You got to get the fullness of Christ in you. See, because I got to speak what the Lord leads me to speak. See, I'm not one. You know, I'm not going to get all tore up about what people think about the messages that the Lord give me. I don't really care. See, because I'm only answering to the Lord. I want to be with Jesus. They're sitting at the table with Him and Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and I'm going to do whatever the Lord wants me to do because He is my eternal judge. I'm not moved and tossed about by every wind of doctrine. I'm not moved by the latest on YouTube. I don't even watch those people anyway. I don't watch no videos on YouTube anyway unless somebody asked me to or the Lord would to tell me to. My brothers and sisters, I praise God if you're watching this video. The Lord has put me on here by His grace as a real ordained minister of God to keep you rooted and grounded in His Word and His Spirit. Hallelujah. God desires for you to have the fullness of the Spirit in you, that it would dwell in you full in the fullness thereof. So I asked you, if you have no desire to be filled with the Spirit of God, how is it that you're a child of God? This is what the Lord wants for us. He said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. All you Judaizers are worried about trying to fulfill, you know, try to follow the Old Testament law and all that stuff, not eating pork and all this kind of stuff. But you're missing the fullness of God. You're missing the things that God's talking about. What did Jesus tell us? You've heard it's been written, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say to you, if you look on a man, if whosoever looks on a woman with lust has committed adultery in his heart. Can you understand what the Lord says when he says that the letter of the law kills, but the spirit of the law brings life? Can you understand? God wants a personal relationship with us. Just as he walked with Adam and Eve in the cool of the day, God wants to walk with us in the cool of the day. What does that mean to walk with somebody and talk with somebody? It's not praying your petitions and all about me, me, me. It's listening to God, seeking God, talking to God, hearing from God, a personal relationship, spending time with God in his word and in prayer and hearing from him, a personal relationship. It's not all of this religion that you got. Get out of your religion and get into God. Get into the real living God. You can use whatever name you want. You can say El Shaddai, God Almighty, El Elyon, the Most High God, Yahweh, Yahuwah, Wah-Bah-Bah-Bah-Way, whatever people are saying, whatever they think they're trying to do. It's all nonsense. God knows who I'm talking to, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name. And kiss his son. Hallelujah, as it says in the Old Testament. Hallelujah. In the book of Psalms, kiss the Son, Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name. Hallelujah. He knows me. That's what he says when you leave this earth. Enter into your rest, my good and faithful servant, or depart from me. I never knew you. Do you know Jesus? How can you say you know Jesus and you don't know the Holy Spirit? How can you say you're a follower of Jesus and talking about following the law? You missed the mark. Jesus said, these Pharisees get it backwards. Jesus said, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the Pharisees, the teachers of the law, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. So they say, oh, I got to keep the law better than they did. No! Your righteousness, it comes by faith through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. God's still on the throne. Now you get off the throne, you old Pharisee, and let Jesus on the throne of your heart, let his grace. By grace you are saved through faith, not of your own, it's a gift of God. Not by works, so that you can't boast. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty for the blood of Jesus and the grace of God he has given to us Gentiles. Hallelujah. Even to Israel. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 15. Acts chapter 15, as the Apostle Paul and the half-brother of Jesus, James, confessed, we're not able to keep the law. How can we ask the Gentiles to do it? We're not able to. No man is able to keep the law. Jesus was the only human that ever lived that kept the law. Hallelujah. He was tempted in every way, but without sin, the Bible says. He was the second Adam. He did what Adam failed to do. He obeyed God when Adam didn't. Hallelujah. Thereby, he has reconciled us to God through his sacrifice. Hallelujah. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. How do we know that? Because the wages of sin, God told Adam, he told Adam, when you eat from the fruit, you'll surely die. The wages of disobeying God is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through keeping the law? No. Through trying to follow the feast days, those appointed times God gave to the nation of Israel to show their covenant? No. By being circumcised, which was under the Old Testament? No. We have eternal life, but the gift of God is eternal life through what? Through Jesus Christ. So as a matter of fact, it's not through what, but who? Through the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise his holy name. God's still on the throne, brothers and sisters. God's still on the throne. He still rules and reigns. Hallelujah. Through the hearts of his people, by the power of his spirit. Now, brothers and sisters, that's what we're about to experience. Now, when the true bride is taken, and I pray to God that we are counted worthy, that you are counted worthy to escape these things, as the Lord Jesus said out of his own mouth, Luke 21, verse 36, talking about the tribulation. He said, watch therefore and pray always that you be counted worthy to escape these things and stand before the Son of Man. Rapture and salvation, not two different things. Two different things. Nobody ever said that salvation is a guarantee of rapture. As a matter of fact, millions and millions of people have died and they didn't get raptured. They died from sickness, disease, whatever, in this world. From the history of the church who were born again, they died. They didn't get raptured. But those who are alive, who are truly part of the bride, who are following Christ, at that point in time of the rapture will be taken. My brothers and sisters, the Lord has led me in all this. I made videos about this. As I made a video, the Lord would show me who would be raptured and who would not. As the Lord has led me in this doctrine to lay it out. Salvation is one thing. Going to heaven and not to hell is one thing. Going in the rapture is another thing. While I mentioned it, I better say it because there's people watching this that haven't heard me talk about this. Revelation chapter 2 and 3. The Lord wrote letters. He had John to write letters to seven different churches. And one church out of seven, the Lord said to one church out of seven, the church of Philadelphia, because you have patiently kept my word, or because you've kept the word of my patience, I will keep you out of the hour of temptations coming on the whole world to try all those people that live on the earth. One out of seven. So there was a requirement to be raptured. In Luke 21, verse 36, he says, pray and watch always, and pray always, not just one time sinner's prayer, pray always to be kind of worthy to escape the tribulation. Then we see, what did we need to do? What does he say? What does it take to be kind of worthy? It's not salvation. He said, because you patiently kept my word. Revelation 3:10. Because you have patiently kept my word. The Lord said to all those churches, repent. Every church but Philadelphia, he said to them, repent therefore of the things that were sins in that church. Repent. We as Christians need to still repent. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the message that the Lord gave me was God's still on the throne. And then when I came on here, the Lord had me do some serious preaching about these people trying to be justified by the deeds of the law. The Bible says, by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified. The Bible also says, when you break one, you've broken them all. So you sin one time and you've already broken the whole law and you're finished. So says the Word of God. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, He is just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Praise God. Praise God. Many of you who have sinned and repented and you keep repenting, and I've said this in a video the other day, don't call God a liar. God's still on the throne. He still has authority to forgive your sins through the blood of Jesus. He's a propitiation of our sin. Jesus is the cover of the mercy seat. He's between us and God. The wrath of God is blocked by Jesus. As it says in John chapter 3, those who are not born again, the wrath of God remains on them.